Dave Mazza, what's going on?
Hey, thanks for having me back.
Absolutely. Well, I can tell you, Dave, this is going to be a heck of a week, man. I mean, right, we get the Fed meeting tomorrow, going to Wednesday. We got Microsoft. We got Apple. We got Tesla. We got the GDP. I mean, where do they want to start?
Yeah, you name it. And look, in the last 2 days, it's been the GameStop market with what's been going on with that particular security. And then you got calls on one hand from world famous investors that were in a bubble. But I think this week is going to separate a lot of that noise, meaning we're gonna get reads from the FOMC, and they're likely going to just confirm what they've been alluding to, that accommodation is here. So what that does is, when we do get this inevitable dip or an inevitable correction, the more people call for a correction, guess what? One day you get one. Might be another buying opportunity here, or definitely at least a trading opportunity. And this week's gonna be special, to your point, with all these big tech earnings coming out, to see just how well they fared navigating, of course, this interesting environment, but also positioning for what eventually is the new normal, as we continue to have this push-pull of what the virus is doing and how fast we can get the science and the vaccines into people's arms.
There's no doubt. And folks, as you go over to the Direction website, you're going to see right on the front page, one of them in particular, work from home, WFH. And the reason I want to bring this up, okay, is that the Supreme Court right now, there's going to be a really cool case. And of course, bottom line, are you in Massachusetts, Dave? You're in Massachusetts, right? Are you working out of New York?
I'm actually in New York.
You're working out of New York. Okay.
We have plenty of folks in Mass, yeah.
Right. So what's going on here, folks, is this, is that New Hampshire and Mass are fighting it out over the aspect of that, okay, there's so many people up in New Hampshire that literally New Hampshire folks are right next to Boston. I mean, you know, it's 45 minutes away. And it's about the tax structure. And so it's really cool. Direction has this ETF, folks, is work from home. Now, this has been very successful anyway because of the way that the allocations and the holdings are. You know what's going to be interesting here, Dave, right? I mean, I heard this morning on the way into work, I says, oh, my God, because it's going to make a difference with the Supreme. So the argument, folks, is this, is that you get a lot of jobs in Massachusetts. The people in New Hampshire have been home now a good, some of them, 6 months. Why should they pay taxes in Massachusetts on top of that? You know, so when I heard that, the first thing I thought of actually was this work from home, because that's going to, I mean, we're in a different era now, there's no doubt. So we'll see what they end up saying about where the taxes are going to be paid. But it looks to me like there's a whole different environment out here now.
That's really the whole point. So, yeah, our work from home ETF, $150 million in assets after launching in June of last year. And it's really about, this is not a leverage fund. But we do have folks who own it for the long term, folks who have gotten in and out of it, depending upon whatever analysis they're doing. But, you know, it's pulled back slightly today, but it was making some new highs last week. As, again, even if people think that we will eventually have a more normalized economic environment, the idea that more folks will be working remotely and not as many folks in the office at one time continues to benefit the names in the portfolio. And these are names that are directly related to what we need for a safe working from home environment. So that's cybersecurity, particularly important when you have folks in disparate locations. You have kind of your content management, document management companies. You have your remote communication companies like your Zooms and your Twilios. But then you also have your cloud companies, right? So your best of clouds are in that portfolio too, to give you that full perspective of what, in our opinion, the 40 stocks that are going to benefit most from this long-term trend toward what I consider to be a hybrid working environment. So some folks in the office, some folks in other locations, swapping out, coming together for when you need to. But also sometimes if you need that day at home, you might actually be more effective. Don't have the commute, or can just, if you have individual work that needs to get done, can do that.
You know what I think is so great too? I think it's great that it's not leveraged. And the reason being, folks, is this. You know, we all wish that we bought Apple when it was like $3. Okay, we know that things have changed. Okay, so you're talking about a fund that's not leveraged. You can take it in your IRA. You can put it wherever you want to put it. And of course, you're in a probability as an investor. But this is a new era, and you're talking about great companies, man. And that's what you have inside this, Dave, which is really cool, man. I mean, you know, we always want to go back in time, but guess what? This is in time in this particular case.